Yeah, it's Nicoletta here, and I'm going to show you how to do your very own marble mug using nail polish. So yeah, let's get started. Right, so what you need is a mug, a plain white mug. Nail polish is any colour you want, two colours or how many colours you want. Nail polish remover if you make any mistakes. Some of these we makeup remover pads, kitchen roll if you need to wipe your fingers on, cocktail sticks if you want to mix in the colours together, which is optional. So, and then a big basin of water. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my nail polish on. So don't throw your nail polish in from a great height, just dip it in real close, just like this. Just like that. Let's go. It mightn't look much gnarly, but once you get it onto your mug, it'll look brilliant. Ooh, the smell. So I'm going to add more lilac. I think the red's a bit domineering right now. It's a little bit finer. I must take this. Remove that top out of the way because it's going to upset things here. Then your cocktail stick, if you want to, just lightly shift things about, just manipulate your paint a bit. You can see that nice shimmer on the red, that's what I wanted. You can even, if you're not happy with the distribution of your purple, you can just add a bit more red. So if you find there's too much purple in one section, and somehow split it up. And see, you can just do that. So obviously you can't put this near your mouth once it's all dried on, because like it's not going to be dishwasher safe. So yeah, I'm just going to grab another cocktail stick, just get a fresh one because the other one's got a bit too gloopy with the amount of. So that should be it. So moment of truth. So you don't have to do the whole entire thing. You actually just dip the bottom in and get part of the handle in. So I might just do that. Make sure I get a proper hold on this. Don't know, hang on, is the best way to do this. Here, I'll just hold it by the handle. So I don't know. Just want to make sure I'm happy with this. Try not to rush it. That's the last thing you need. Don't want to ruin this. See, that's. Be careful with those wee thick parts. Just try and push them out of the way because you don't want lumps on your wonderful mug. You can try and avoid it. Right, so here goes. I am going to do this. So I think I'll just do this. How awesome is that? You know, it doesn't have to be all the way up. It doesn't have to cover the whole entire mug. Right. Now, I'm going to let this dry. If you can. That is awesome. That's actually turned out better than I expected. And I've even covered a part of the handle, which is decently good. You know. Look at that. So. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure it's just water, isn't it? I think it is. So I'm going to have to let that dry. So yeah. It's actually, some of it's dry already, but you know, I don't want to be a bit too cocky at this stage. Where can I set this mug? Set it over here so you can all see it properly. nice. Oh my god. It's like, did I have a wish? There's a wee bit. But sure, that's at the bottom. What's it matter? There's another bit anyway, sure. Doesn't matter. So you can either, if you want to cheat, you can blow dry that, which I might actually do. So just to speed things up. So yeah, that wee mug was from Home Bargains for what? Pound? No, not Home Bargains. Matalan for £2, sorry. Matalan for £2. Can't go wrong with that. It's a decent sized mug. So before you start this, you make sure your mug's nice and washed, free of dust. And that. So yeah, I'll be back once it's dried. So I'm going to treat you guys to another mug, dipping. This time I'm using yellow, and like a nice, I don't know, a turquoise blue almost, like a, it's a real summery colour. So this time it's going to be a different type of a mug, nice wee, almost a vintage type of mug. So what way I'm going to do this, probably going to do it similar, but I don't know, do a wee bit more. Yeah, it's just getting a proper grip on it. So you can see, look, this time I haven't used any of the cocktail sticks because I managed to make the lines a lot more solid, like a Jackson Pollock style here going on. So actually make sure you have the label peeled off the bottom. In we go. So if you get some of the nail polish in there, don't worry, you can take it off with your nail polish remover. So if you want to have another go, if you want to dip in again, just take it from a different angle. So I'm going to have to set this down and pick it up again. Not so, yeah, I don't know if you... Goodness. The label I don't want. So I think I'll actually do, but you know, if you want to have a second bash at it, just layer it up again. Or it's not that bad. Maybe cut some of the handle. Get some of the handle in. Not if you're not pleased with some of it, you can just remove it with your nail polish. But like, looks okay from what I've got at the minute. So I will show you how to remove the inside mistakes, which you don't want. So again, upside down so you can let it dry, just like that. So yeah, it's your two mugs, so I will be back once they are dry. So here's the two mugs completely finished. The purple and red one, and then the yellow and blue one. So the reason why I went for the white is obviously the colours stand out better, because if you got black the colours wouldn't be so bold. And so yeah, as you can see, I left where my mouth was going to be free. You don't need to cover it all, just like that. I like this one. And then again, the mouth area free, so you just make it look like it's like that, you know. It's like, yeah, right now. So as you seen earlier, there's a lot of paint that got in here. So I cleaned it out with one of those makeup removers, and then it tidied up the bottom. No paint got into here, which was good. So I tidied up the bottom as well, and you can just tidy up. So some paint got onto the handle here at the top part, which I didn't really like, so I just tied it up with a nail bud thing. And there's actually a bit of texture on this, which I kind of like, actually. And yeah, it turned out really well. I liked it. If I can just... So, that's my mugs done. And yeah, so that's how you do your nail polish marble mugs. And that's, so yeah, see ya.